Now let's talk about some issues with pipelining. So one limitation on pipelining is something called non-uniform partitioning. And this is when the logic segments in the CPU have significantly different links. It's impossible to split CPU logic into exactly equal intervals. And when the divisions are particularly lopsided, you end up with the really undesirable situation where you may have some portions of time where the CPU isn't actually doing anything because it only has one, it only has a few instructions in the pipeline, and it's executing a stage that has very little logic, and so you actually end up wasting some time. In some sense, this is unavoidable, but you want to try to minimize it to the extent possible when you're designing your CPU. Another problem is the problem of dependencies. So some things just aren't serial. In many places, the effect of one instruction depends on the result of another, and so you really have to wait for some result from that previous instruction in order to execute one of the following instructions. There are two types of dependencies that we'll talk about. So there are data dependencies and control dependencies, and both of these are referred to as hazards for pipelining because they prevent pipelining from happening. So here's an example of a data dependency over here. So there's a load instruction, an add, and then a we'll load into a register, an add, and then a load into or store into memory. And so it's worth pausing at this point and seeing if you can identify where are the individual parts of these instructions that create data dependencies. Where is one instruction reliant on another instruction finishing first? So pause the video and think about that. So hopefully it's relatively straightforward in this case. So here we need the value of RAX in order to execute this add instruction. But the previous instruction is setting RAX. And so we need to know that RAX, need to know the value of RAX before we can begin executing this instruction. Similarly, we need RBX in order to do this store. This is a load, sorry. In order to execute this load, we need the value of RBX, and we won't know that until we finish executing this add instruction. So both of these are data dependencies, and both of these we're going to cause problems in pipelining. Control dependencies are a little bit more subtle. So here's an example of a control dependency. So we do a subtraction instruction, and then based on the results of that subtraction, so that's a data dependency as well. But the other problem here is that we don't know whether or not we're going to take this jump until we actually look at the condition codes. So we can't go ahead and start executing this instruction or this instruction until we know which one we're going to actually execute. So that's an example of a control dependency. So how do we get around these things? So there are various approaches to avoiding hazards. Obviously, you could just halt execution when you encounter a hazard, or you could throw an exception. Obviously, this is not a good way of handling these things. The other sort of naive way of handling these things is to just sort of pause and stall until the data that we need, or until we until the data that we need is calculated, or we have determined whether or not we're taking a jump, for instance. And so you're basically holding back an instruction temporarily. So this has the advantage of resolving the hazards, but it increases the amount of time that it takes for the instructions to execute. Another thing you can do if you have a data dependency is something called data forwarding. And this is a clever trick in CPU design that allows later stages to feed data back to earlier stages so that you can get results sooner than waiting for them to propagate to memory or registers. And so this is useful for data dependencies and allows things like the example shown on the previous slides to execute pipelined, even though some of the instructions need some of the results of a previous instruction. All right, there's also branch prediction. This is useful for resolving control dependencies. And the idea is that, well, we don't know which direction this particular jump is going to go, but maybe we can make a pretty good guess. Or, you know, maybe we'll just guess anyway. And maybe we're wrong and we have to roll back some work. But if we can guess right a significant amount of the time, then we can just go ahead and start executing that instruction. And then we'll be ahead once we have verified that that was where we needed to go. So we're not going to talk in too much detail about how all these work, but again, the textbook does cover these a lot more extensively, so if you're interested, I would encourage you to read those sections in the textbook. At this point, hopefully we can have a greater understanding as well about why we would want a conditional move in our instruction set. So remember that a conditional move is similar to a conditional jump, except that it moves data rather than taking a branch or a jump based on condition codes. And so now we can see that the benefit here is that we don't have to guess where we're going to go, and so there will be no branch prediction penalty. And what this means is that we'll have improved performance in the presence of pipelining. So here's an example where there's sort of a subtle benefit to using a particular one particular kind of instruction over another. And this results in real-life performance improvements, and that's why it's important to understand these details. So here's just a quick example. So here's some C code, and then what the C code would turn into in Y86 code using a conditional jump on the left-hand side and a conditional move on the right-hand side. And so you can see that not only is the code on the right shorter, but it also only has a data dependency regarding the condition codes. It doesn't actually have any control dependencies. We don't have to guess where we're going to go. And so if we were going to execute these, it's likely that on a pipelined processor, like most are these days, that the code on the right is going to, on the whole, execute faster than the code on the left.